welcome to the first installment of Teddy's Tips. I'm Teddy, and I will be talking to you about CV and CC mode, more commonly known as constant voltage and constant current mode of the power supply. This can be found in most of our power supplies, and I will be discussing to you how to reach CV or CC mode, what it is, and how it affects your system. So, as I said before, I will be explaining CV and CC mode, more commonly known as constant voltage and constant current mode of the power supply. In CV mode, the power supply tries to keep the voltage at a constant value. And in constant current mode, the power supply tries to keep the current at a constant value. So let me begin this by drawing this graph. So when we program the power supply, the voltage limit, and the current limit, let's say we set it at 50 volts and 100 milliamps. That forms a graph looking like this, where this region is CC mode, and that region is CV mode. But how do you get in CC or CV mode? Well, an important concept to take away from this is that there is no setting on the power supply to set, oh, I want to be in CV or CC mode. No. The way you go into either CV mode and CC mode is through Ohm's law, through the load that you connect to the power supply. So if we look at Ohm's law here, I equals V over R, and we have these two limits of 50 volts and 100 milliamps. We see that our critical resistance is 500 ohms. This is called critical resistance because if you attach a load that is greater than 500 ohms, let's say we have 60 or 600 ohms, and we have 50 volts and 600 ohms, by Ohm's law, the current that it will be trying to pull is about 0.083 amps, meaning that it will be in CV mode, since you're not slamming into this 100 milliamp limit. Now, if you have less resistance than this critical resistance, and you have 400 ohms, the current that the load will try to pull is about 0.125 amps, forcing the power supply into CC mode, because it will slam into this current limit of 100 milliamps, and the power supply put on the brakes and say, no, I'm not going to let you go past this 100 milliamps, and regulate it at 100 milliamps. But this will break the laws of physics if we have 100 milliamps, 50 volts, and 400 ohms, because you'll be at only 100 milliamps, but it will be wanting to pull 0.125 amps. So, since it pulls you into CC mode, the voltage will need to drop down. So at this point, you will see that the power supply, through Ohm's law, so 100 milliamps times 400 ohms, will equal about 40 volts. So as you can see, it's the resistance or the load that you put onto the power supply that determines if you are in constant voltage or constant current mode. And we look at first the voltage in determining the constant voltage or constant current mode, because the power supplies are optimized to operate as constant voltage power supplies. So that's why we first look at the voltage and look at the load that we connect to it, and determine if the current is reaching the current limit or not. So we will demonstrate these properties in our next segment on an actual power supply, an actual electronic load. So I hope that this clears up any doubt you might have had about this. And hope you enjoy our next segment.